bring it to a shrine, really. Yeah.
It has been said already, but for my part, I think that he did indeed bring a touch of feeling to the great office of the Governor-Generalship. I didn't know him personally, although I'd met him once or twice. He was a great Australian, and I guess the thing that I'm particularly conscious of today is that along with Sir John Monash and Sir Isaac Isaacs, he has probably been the greatest Jew that Australia has produced.
And
given the extraordinary qualities of the Jewish people, that makes him a remarkable man indeed. Jewish people like to observe Australia is the one country on earth apart from Israel where you've had a Jewish head of the army, a Jewish head of the judiciary, and a Jewish head of state.
It's pretty remarkable. We are fortunate to live in such a free country.
I'm told I've got to go.
Thanks,
good to
Tony
see you.
His appointment was probably the best appointment I ever made.
Good on you. Thanks, Mel.
Sir Zelman's an iconic figure of Australian history. Not just the Jewish community, he belongs to all of the Australian people.
What I wanted to ask you about was, what do you think the legacy of Sir Zelman Cowen was?
Well, I think he will leave a profound, or has left a profound legacy. Principally, in his role as Governor General, he restored the public's faith and trust in that office. That was extremely important to the stability of Australia then, as it is now. Secondly, in terms of education, he elevated legal scholarship as well as tertiary education to a new level. And I think that has going to have a profound impact on many, many people for years to come. And speaking at a personal level, as one of those people who were mentored by Sir Zelman, he was an inspiration. And he always taught us to think for ourselves and the importance of principles and values. And for me, in my career and in my life, I keep thinking back to what Sir Zelman taught me as a guide, as a roadmap for my years to come.
I had a relationship with Sir Zelman, who I called Zelman, because that's then you know you have a relationship with him, right? If you can call him by his first name, and he was always, to me, the epitome of the gentleman.
That's a very good.
He really was an inspiration to me as well, and I really feel for his family. I think it's been a long road, and they've really been amazingly strong through it. And Zelman was, I saw him last week. You were there on the day that he passed away?
I was, but he never sought pity.
No, never.
He never complained, and he had Parkinson's disease, which is a debilitating disease.
And we saw him deteriorate over the last 8 or 10 years. And
but he still still retained two things, a sharpness of mind and a fantastic memory, but also humour and wit.
Yeah.
And that came through, I thought, today in the funeral service, because a lot of people remarked on his humour and wit, which was always there.
Always. And I always had the giggle with him. We always had a little kind of, just a smile that would just open your heart, you know, just touch you. He was very touched. I was always touched by every gesture that he made, and thought he was just a wonderful human being.
The other thing, Henry, is he was a great contributor to Jewish community causes. And as the rabbi said, he was never just a patron on paper. He was an active participant, and he supported so many causes, Jewish and non-Jewish, but particularly in his sense of Jewish identity was very strong. And for me, as a Jewish boy in Melbourne, aspiring to different things and greater things, I look to Sir Zelman as somebody who could achieve that. That in this wonderful country that is Australia, he was somebody who, through his sheer determination and capacity, was able to achieve the highest office in the land.
And he had a love for opera, let's not forget.
And music. He was a Renaissance man, as was remarked today.
That's the word I was going to say. You beat me to it.
Well, music.
He was.
Architecture. That was. He was even the patron to the St Kilda Football Club, which was important to him.
Hail the Saints. Yeah, that's something we had in common. And he was, to me, Saint Zelman. And I actually saw him a couple of times at the footy, and it was always a thrill. Yeah. He was a very passionate saint. And now he's no longer with us, but it's a big pair of shoes to fill.
Well, I don't think anyone's going to fill them, but I think what we can do is remember his contribution to so many organisations, the way he touched so many people, the way he was a leader, both in our Jewish community as well to the broader Australian population.
Well, I'd really like to thank you so much for coming along and being our very special guest on this occasion. And we will remember Sir Zelman as one of the greatest Australians to ever live.
Absolutely.
And we're going out with some exclusive footage from Sir Zelman's last appearance in public, which was at the Jewish Museum, of which he was a patron and always a supporter from the very first day. And we won't be back live until next year, so this is our last show. We were going to do a Hunter Chris show, but we're doing, over the next 7 weeks, we'll be presenting some repeats and highlights of the shtick, and we'll see you on air live as such in 2012. So happy Hanukkah, Merry Christmas, Happy New Year, and Josh,
and a long life,
Henry. And a long life to you, and best wishes in your political career.
And best wishes to you and your listeners.
Thank you. Viewers.
Viewers.
And they're listening too.
And they're listening.
I hope you're listening. Shalom.
I'd like to see a society always concerned with fair shares. I hope we preserve tolerance. I hope that it's a society in which a man can say, I have a chance, I've had a chance. I hope that it's a society which can provide opportunities like those that have been provided for me. The luck is incredible. I believe that the luck is incredible. I look on things as the great good fortune that everything fell into place. Something that you never contemplated came to be. Then you seize it, and your duty is to do with it the best you can, whatever that may be.